Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're proud to announce that LaunchBox 13.3 for Windows has been released, along with LaunchBox for Android 1.9. And like all of our new releases, we've got some fixes, improvements, and some awesome new features. And with 13.3, we've added a new feature that we've been working on for quite a while, and we've had a lot of requests from the community to implement this in LaunchBox, and now with this release, we can sync our game statistics to the cloud, and we can sync up between our installations of LaunchBox across the board. So if you've got an install on your laptop, your PC, and let's say an arcade cabinet, we can now use our LaunchBox Games database account to sync our favorites, completed, last played, play time, play count, and star rating fields, so we can sync this across all of our LaunchBox builds to make it really easy to get those last played, play time, play count, so on and so on, synced up between our LaunchBox setups. And this also goes hand in hand with the new release of LaunchBox for Android 1.9 because we've also got the sync option in the Android version. So if you sync over here on your PC running Windows with the newest version of LaunchBox 13.3, it will sync up with 1.9 in Android. And this is very simple to use, but you will need a LaunchBox Games database account. And this is separate from our LaunchBox Forum account, so you will need to create one. And in order to do this, we're going to head up to Tools, Cloud, connect to the LaunchBox Games database. Now, if you've already got an account, you can sign in here, but we can register. It's going to open up a web page for us. And from here, we'll just sign up. Email, password, you can create a gamer tag. Once we're registered, we're going to close this down and connect to the LaunchBox Games database. We'll just use the email and password we created for that account, sign in, and from here we can enable the new sync function. So we'll choose yes, and this is going to sync our favorites, completed, last played, play time, play count, and star rating fields to all of our LaunchBox installations that are signed in to our LaunchBox Games database account. It's going to do the sync in the background for us, and it could take a little while depending on how much you have, but I think mine should be about finished. Once it's finished, we now have all of that synced to the cloud, and it should be mentioned that right now I'm actually using a custom theme. This is known as Big Details. With custom themes, in order to get this little sync button up here, they will need to be updated. It's a sync status button, and when we hover over it, you can see that we're in sync right now. It'll give us our last scan date and time. We can click on it. It'll give me a green check mark letting me know that the sync is working properly. But just as an example, I've just disconnected my Wi-Fi. If I go up here again, it'll give me an exclamation point letting me know that the sync isn't working correctly. And this is due to me not having internet right now. And Big Details, the theme that I'm using right now, has been updated to have this sync button. And now what I've done is just move over to another PC that I have LaunchBox and BigBox set up on. We'll go ahead and start it up. From Tools, we're going to go to Cloud, connect to the LaunchBox Games database. We're going to sign in on this PC. Tools, Cloud, enable Game Statistic Syncing. So now, I've got a bunch of favorites set up with that other build. It synced them over here, so if I find my favorite section, and all of my favorites have been synced to this build. So these are ones that I favorited on my other build of LaunchBox. They're here now because we've synced it up with that LaunchBox Games Database Cloud. So again, this new cloud feature will sync your favorites, completed, last played, play time, play count, and star ratings for your games. And this is really awesome because we can bring it across to all of our LaunchBox builds. Whether you have a couple PCs set up, a laptop, a handheld, and an arcade machine, you can sync it across the board and bring all of that information over there very easily, including the latest release of LaunchBox 1.9 for Android. And just as a reminder, sync button here with the default theme. We can go ahead and make sure everything's working correctly. We've got that green check mark, and we're good to go with the sync. Now, along with the new sync option in 13.3, we've got some other new features that I wanted to cover real quick. Now, first up, 3D models. We can now override specific games when it comes to the new 3D box models or the new 3D case models. And this comes in really handy for totally customizing your collection. So as we know, some games did come in different box formats, and LaunchBox does a great job with kind of setting that up for us right off the bat. For instance, in the US, Sega Saturn had the long jewel cases. PlayStation 1 games had their regular jewel cases. But there are platforms where games were released in more than one type of container, and I'll give you a quick idea here. Now I'm just in my Windows section. In order to edit these 3D box models, we're going to right-click on a specific game, Edit, Edit Metadata and Media. From here, we've got the 3D model setting. So this is going to be specifically for this game, Half-Life. I'm going to override the default settings. We can actually rotate it right here. But we can change this to, let's say, a jewel case. Now, as we know, some of these older PC games just came in a little jewel case. I've actually got a few of them laying around. You can go with a long jewel case if you want to. And in the future, we will be implementing more 3D box models, like double jewel cases and things like that. But this is really awesome for just kind of customizing your whole collection. Looks really good in big box with one of my favorite themes. Three dimensions. I mean, we can totally customize these if we want to. If you wanted to set this up with jewel cases, DVD boxes, or just boxes in general, you can go through and individually change each game. We've also overhauled the Wii U and PS3 import process. Now we've got parsing support for Wii U and PS3. Basically, if I start this import process for, let's say, Wii U, I'm just going to add my folder here. We're going to go with Wii U. Got three games in here real quick using the SimU emulator. LaunchBox will now automatically scan those game folders and find the correct file. For Wii U, it's an RPX file. This is exactly what we need. An eBoot for PS3. So we no longer have to go in and kind of weed out those other files that may be imported. This makes it really easy to get your Wii U and PS3 games up and running in LaunchBox. And the final thing I wanted to touch on here is more of an improvement. LaunchBox has now been upgraded to .NET 6.0. We used to use .NET Core 3.1, and that would require a separate install. But with the latest update to 13.3, we've implemented .NET 6.0, and it's all integrated, so we don't need a separate download. When we install LaunchBox, it's automatically going to install everything for us. So yeah, we hope you enjoy LaunchBox for Windows 13.3 and LaunchBox for Android 1.9. If you've got any questions, definitely let us know in the comments below, and keep an eye on the YouTube channel and the forum, because we've always got a lot coming. But like always, thanks for watching.